afternoon, students of class 2. How are you all? I hope that you all are fine and doing great at your homes. First of all, tell me, did you enjoy your yesterday's lesson? How was it? Was there any difficulty? That's great. So let's start our today's lesson with the date and day. Abdul Rahman is going to tell me the date today. What is the date today? Yes, today is 21st of January 2021. That's great. And Sana is going to tell me what is the day today. Today is Thursday. Can you tell me the spellings of Thursday? Subhan, you are going to tell me the spellings of Thursday. Come on, quickly. It would be fun if we were having interactive class, but obviously we are going through hard times and this is a video lesson. But don't worry, I'll try to make it interesting for you all. Today we are going to do a very interesting activity just by using some resources, just as some books. Here I have three books, 1, 2, and 3. As you can all see, that this book is small, this one is bigger, and this one is the biggest. In all of three books, I can say that the pink book is smaller than the green book. In the green book is smaller than the blue book. So, which terms I am using over here? Smaller and small. The pink book is small. The green book is smaller than the blue one. And the pink is the smallest. So, if I have to use three terms of small, smaller, and smallest, what will I use? I'll say blue book is the small, green is smaller than the blue one, and the pink is the smallest of all. जो book सबसे छोटी है, उसके लिए जो term हम use करते हैं, that is the smallest. Whenever we are comparing anything, if I say, I have three books, 1, 2, and 3. This is book number 3, this is book number 2, and this is book number 1. The terms that I have to use over here is small, smaller, and smallest. It means small ka matlab hota hai chota. Smaller means whenever we are comparing two things, हम दो चीजों को आपस में compare कर रहे होते हैं, तो उसके लिए जो term use होती है, that is the smaller, in which we add er with our term, er with the small. और जो सबसे छोटा होती है, सबसे छोटी चीज होती है उन तमाम चीजों में, वे एवर इफ वी हैव टू थिंग्स, थ्री थिंग्स, फोर थिंग्स और मोर देन इट, तो वी विल ऐड ईएसटी. सो आई विल से बुक वन. हाउ विल आई मेक सेंटेंस? बुक वन इज स्मॉल. But now I am comparing my book 2 with the book 1. Or I can compare my book 2 with the book 3. I can compare book 3 with book 2. I can compare book 3 with book 1. So whenever I am doing the comparison, I will use the term smaller. So which book is smaller? Book 3 is smaller than book 2. And book 2 is smaller than book 1. So I can use any book. Here I am going to say book 2 is smaller than book 1. Book 2 is smaller than book 1. And now I have to use this term, the smallest. So which book is the smallest? Book 3 is the smallest. So, book 3 is the smallest of all. Okay? Do you get it how we do this thing? Let's take another example that how we can make sentences using different objects. To make this thing more clear to you, I am going to take another example over here. So let's do that.
Oh, you are thirsty.
If I say I have three different shapes over here, a square, a circle, and a star. If I say I have three different shapes, a square, a circle, and a star. The size of them is probably the same.
Let's make it bigger.
Okay, I have a square, a circle, and a star. The terms that I am going to use over here is bigger, smaller, smallest, and biggest. Four terms. Bigger, smaller, bigger, smaller, biggest, and smallest. So here I have four terms, the four terms which I am going to use to compare the shapes that I have over here. Square, circle, and the star. So what will I say? Square is bigger than the circle. Square is bigger than the circle. Square is bigger than the circle. As we can see that this square is bigger than the circle. So my first term is fulfilled. The second one that I am going to use over here is smaller. I can say that The circle is smaller than the square. You see, the circle is smaller than the square. I can also say that the star is smaller than the circle. So, let's make it easy. I said square is bigger than the circle. Now, circle is smaller than the square. Circle is smaller than the square. Circle is smaller than the square. Now I have the second term as well. Let's move to the third one. Biggest. Which one is the biggest of all? In all these three shapes, which shape is the biggest? Yes, Tanya, you tell me. Hajra. Which shape is the biggest of all? Yes, square is the biggest. Square is the biggest. And we are left with the last term. Smallest. Which shape is smallest of all? Which shape is the smallest? Star is the smallest. Right? So fourth one is star is the smallest. Star is the smallest. So you see that you were given four different terms: bigger, smaller, biggest and smallest. By using these terms, you were comparing different shapes. You can compare different objects through them. And we have fulfilled our purpose. The first one we have over here is the square, then the circle, and then we have star. The square is bigger than the circle. The circle is smaller than the square, and the square is the biggest, and the star is the smallest. Smallest, biggest, smaller, bigger. All these terms are used. Okay? Are you all clear? Let's do another example of this to make it more clear to you all. Draw fruits. Well, I am bad at drawing, but I'll try to make it for you all.
Wow.
Yes, it's mango. Right? And what is this? Yes, it's an apple. It's an apple. So, again, we have the same terms. Smaller, bigger, smallest, and biggest. Smaller, bigger, smallest and biggest. Okay? Smaller, bigger, smallest and biggest. The first sentence you are going to tell me. Sara, come on, tell me. Apple is smaller than orange. Now I'm starting from here. Apple is smaller than orange. Apple is smaller than orange. Now, orange is bigger than apple. I can also make two more sentences by writing mango is bigger than orange and orange is smaller than mango. So you can choose any two fruits or objects to compare them. The next one is smallest. So which of them is the smallest? Apple. Apple is the smallest. Is the smallest. And which one is the biggest? Mango is the biggest. So we have used all of them: smaller, bigger, smallest, and biggest. This is how you have to compare different objects, different things. There is an assignment given on page number 89 and 90 of your book, of which you have to make sentences. You can choose any four examples and then you will have to make sentences on them. Okay? So you have to choose any four parts from the question number 1 given on page number 89 and 90 of your book, and then you have to make these comparative sentences. Okay, so the assignment is easy. Till then, complete your assignment and take good care of yourselves. Stay home, stay safe. Allah Hafiz.